Today, you'll learn how to create a custom WordPress theme without writing any code. And we'll be using SeedProd to turn our website from looking like this into something like this. So let's dive in. SeedProd is a drag and drop WordPress page builder for businesses, bloggers, and website owners. To get started, you'll want to either have the pro or elite plan. So you want to come over to seedprod.com to purchase your plugin. Once you go through and create the account that you need, you can log in to SeedProd. Once you log in, you'll want to download the plugin. And then while we're here, let's go ahead and also copy our license key. And then we need to head back over to our WordPress dashboard so we can install the plugin. From our dashboard, we'll go over to plugins, add new, and we want to upload the plugin. From the upload, you can choose file, or if you have the plugin down at the bottom, like I do, you can left click, drag it up. Otherwise, choose the file to find it on your computer. Go ahead and click install now. And then we also want to activate the plugin. Great. Now that it's activated, we want to enter our license key. So I'll right click and paste the license key that I copied, and we can verify key. And you should see a nice green valid license key pop up. So you see, once we've installed it, we have this theme builder over on the left. So let's click on this. Now from here, you have two different options to choose from. You can first just start creating the theme from scratch, and that would just start creating everything that you need. Or you can save time and by going off of a base theme. So you can pick a theme that's closely related to how you want your website to look, and then you can adjust from there. And starting with a ready-made theme is actually how we prefer it and how we recommend it, because you just get farther faster. So here are all of the themes that are currently out at the time of this recording. You can choose any of these to get started, and absolutely everything on here that you see in these themes can be customized. So for this one, we're going to start with the starter theme as our base for customizing our theme. Now, this is the draft version of the theme. We haven't yet set it live yet. And don't worry, we'll do that later on in the video. From here, you can choose to edit any and all of these theme templates. Now, a theme is made up of several theme parts, and these are all of the different theme templates that come together to create a full theme. For instance, you have a single page, a single post. So when somebody clicks on a blog post and reads it, this is the part of the post that is the layout for that. You have the blog index, or when someone goes to, say, your blog page, that shows up all of the posts on one page. And then we have the home page, sidebar, footer, and header. So for this, we can customize the home page. So we're going to go ahead and edit design. And this is what it looks like. So this is actually the header template, and that's coming in. That would be customized at the template area, but this just brings us in to show you what that looks like with your home page. And then these are all of the elements on your page. With SeedProd, it goes into sections, and then you have columns, and then you have rows, and then you might even have blocks with items in it. So it's a really nice hierarchical structure that you can make changes to. So we'll just make a couple of changes to show you what this looks like. You can either do it here, or you can come over to the left and make those changes here. And notice under the blocks, we have all of these blocks that you can choose from as well. The template tags you would use a little bit more, and I'll show you this in a minute. And that's more of bringing in dynamic information on, say, a blog or a blog post. So you have those, and then you have your standard items like text, list, image. For instance, I'll change out this image. And what's great about SeedProd is you can either upload your own image, or you can choose an image from stock image, and they have millions of images that you can choose from. And then if you scroll even further, you have advanced blocks, and these are items like a giveaway, a contact form that'll bring it in. You can also add your social profiles. So we can choose how to pull in and drag and drop these. And then once we click on it, we can make adjustments. The final set of blocks that we have is, if you scroll all the way down, if you have a WooCommerce store on your website, then you have all of these items that you can customize. For instance, you can completely customize your checkout, your featured products, and so much more. The other cool feature is you have areas for icons. So if you want to do an image, but you don't want to do an actual image, maybe you want to do an icon instead, you can choose from several different icons that they have. You can also bring in font awesome icons if you would prefer those. Now, getting back to the template tags, if we go back to our blocks area, these are the template tags that I was talking about, where they bring in dynamic content, meaning they can bring in posts and items from your WordPress database. So if I want to put the most recent posts on my homepage, I can do something quickly by bringing in a column, make it a full column layout. And then I want to come up here and grab my posts, and then I can drag them on here. And then it loads. And then from here, I can choose how I want this to look. And then I could show the featured image. And if these blog posts had featured images, then they would come in as well. And then down here, you also have the mobile preview, where when you click on it, then you can see just what the site will look like on mobile. If there's anything that you don't like or you want to remove something, simply can go to undo or redo. Then you also have revision history. If you've saved multiple revisions, then you can go back to a previous history as well. As you're going through and making changes, you not only do you have these blocks that you can choose from, but you also have sections. And sections are like a collection of blocks. You have all of these sections that you can choose from. And then once you find something that you want to bring in, simply click on the plus button, and then that will bring it all the way down to the bottom. If you need to delete anything, you can just come up and delete, and it'll delete out that whole section. And once you're finished with all of your changes, you can come up here and just click save. Now we can go back, and then you can choose what other items to customize. For instance, say we want to customize what a blog index looks like. So when we edit the design, this is the layout of what the blog looks like. So it'll automatically bring in all of this information. As you see, archive title, this automatically brings in the archive or the category name. And this is pulling in dynamic information. Here you can also choose how you want this to look. The query type is default. You can do custom or manual. So custom, you can choose what you want to bring in, and then you can look at the layout. By default, the layout is just one column. The first 10 items are shown. This is where you can pull in the image and how to show the titles. Here you can choose to show the author, date, time, and the comment count if you have any comments. As you're working on the blog, you'll also notice a couple of other things. For instance, as you see, we still have the header template area that is customized from the header template area. Then you also see that you have other template parts. For instance, this is the sidebar, and you see over on the left, it is a template part of the sidebar. If we wanted to make changes to what this looks like, then we would have to edit that template part, and then that would come in. So I'm going to save this, and then we can go back and look at a couple of other items. You also have the header area that you can change the design of that. And what we're changing is everything up here. For this, we have the rows area, and we can change this. And I already showed you that you could use stock images, or you can also upload your own. From here, we can change the color that we want, or if we already know the color that we want, we can pick that and put that in here. Great. And then that is our main header. Now we can exit out of this. And then one more area that I want to show you is your global CSS. Normally you have to know a bunch of CSS in order to get the global settings like your font or your size or your colors, things like that. The global settings, you can just come in here and you can quickly see what all of those items will look like, and you can make those changes here. So if I click on the button area, we can make the changes here. We can choose blue because that's been the dominant color theme throughout. You can choose to do gradient. You can also choose what it will look like on hover. And then you can see what that looks like. Now, by default, these global CSS, they come from the theme that we created. In this case, it was the starter theme. So it brought in all of those custom global settings from there. And then you can go in and make changes even further here. And then what's cool is the global CSS template will let you see a preview of all the changes that you make before they actually go live. Once you're done with everything, we can again click Save Changes. And now our theme is ready to go. So one final thing that you want to do is you want to come to the main theme builder area, and then you want to enable the theme. So we'll click Yes. And now that that's been enabled, now we can open it up and see what it looks like. Now that you have that, there's like so many other things that you can do with this. Your mind starts to race on the other things that you can do. For instance, you could create for your popular archive pages or your popular category pages, you could create something completely different. Maybe change this up in the top, maybe bring up a different image up here and set it to just your particular category that's one of your most popular ones. Or maybe you want to have a completely different header template to your theme that only displays on certain categories. Or what if you want to create specific landing page for like a sales page or a webinar? Well, SeedProd still does that amazingly well with their landing page area. Just come up here to landing pages and you can create a landing page from all of the templates that they have for you to choose from. So if you want to get started today with SeedProd, just head over to seedprod.com. And now we'll be showcasing SeedProd a lot more in the future videos. And now let me know in the comments below, what type of website would you want to see me create using SeedProd? And thanks for watching.